Hi, welcome back down to the basement. It's Dan here once again. We are in the Guitar Interactive magazine studio and we are checking out the Warwick Corvette Double-Buck GPS model. This thing is a beast. There is so many tones available on this, but you know what? Let's do the usual. Let's get down and look at the details. Straight up, headstock, here we go. Two aside tuners on this one, and I am a big fan of small headstocks on basses. Do you know what? Actually, I even like basses that don't have headstocks at all, but that's another story completely. Over to the Warwick, we have the cool Warwick logo here, and we're going to come down this neck. What I'm going to do is I'm going to flip the bass over because you can see the wonderful front of the bass, but you have got to see this. Check this out. I'm going to flick the bass over. This is a three-piece laminate Ovancol neck. Have a close look at this grain. How beautiful is that? Really, really nice. Coming down the back of the neck, you can see it is skinny as. So I'm gonna just roll the bass a little bit so James can get a good look at the profile here. It's a skinny jazz bass kind of profile. Like so. Coming down, slowly down the back of the body as well. You can see we've got this lovely bolt-on joint here with this lovely stepped heel. Big thumbs up, I absolutely love this. Get those big blocks of wood out of the way. Beautiful grain, look at this. Ocean blue is the finish on this one. I love that you can see this is US swamp ash on this one. And then compartment for all the electronics. Love this, no screws. We can just pop this open with your nail and you can get in and change the battery for the electronics here. Spin the bass over, I'll draw your attention to the top horn. And we have got some nice Warwick strap locks as standard. So no needing to go out and buy separate bits and bobs. You can lock your strap onto the bass and this, you know, comes with the instrument. Okay, let's go and have a look back up at the headstock and we're gonna come down the fretboard. Warwick's Just a Nut 3, I think is the model on this, an adjustable nut. So if you're finding it's not high enough or too low, whatever, you can actually adjust the height of the nut to suit your playing style. Out of the box though, this is bang on, spot on, I've got no problems with that whatsoever. 38 mil nut, this is about 1.5 inch. As I said, jazz neck profile. Coming down the neck onto the dots on the top, I'm gonna flip this over. These, although we're not in dark, so I can't tell, these are glow-in-the-dark dots. So you can charge those with a torch and zoom off onto your dark stage and still be able to see where you are, which is really, really awesome. Round onto the front. And interestingly, this is a Wenge fretboard. And look at this, beautifully naked, no dots on it. And I don't know if you can get in close on this one, But the grain is, wow, it's as sexy as the back of the neck as well. It's really lovely. 24 frets on this model. Absolutely fitted. Perfect, beautiful. Can't even feel them down the edge of the neck. And this is a nice, small sized neck. Or it doesn't feel like too skinny. It still feels like it's a nice feel of wood in your hand, I suppose. And as I said, no dot markers, so you can keep your audience guessing where you are on the fretboard. Coming down, I've got to show you this grain again. Beautiful top, really, really lovely. And we come down here and we've got two passive MEC humbuckers. And with these two models, we've got a couple of switches here where we can reconfigure each pickup from a serial wiring, a single coil wiring, or a parallel wiring. And this is going to affect the sound of each pickup. So there's our switches here. And we'll have a listen to those in a moment. Don't worry, we've got to hear this bass. Master volume. Around here, we have got our pan control to pan between the front or back or mixture of the two pickups. And then around here, active bass and treble here with loads of boost and cut to do extra sort of sculpting, I suppose, on your tone. Two-piece bridge, nice and chunky. Nice action on this straight out of the box, nice and comfy. And it looks really, really nice in this sort of chrome finish as well. It really goes nicely with the blue, I think. Right, let's stop talking. Let's have a little listen. In the introduction, the mode of the pickups is we're using two single coils, so only half of each pickup. So quick reminder of what that sounds like, then we're gonna listen to each half. Then I'm gonna zoom through. So we've got single, parallel, and serial mode. And in the serial mode, you're gonna hear lots more volume because the two halves of the pickup are being summed, and a nice boost in the mid-range as well, which is great for cutting through. Okay, so this is my, let's have a little look, single coil and single coil setting. Halfway in the middle, there's a nice little click on the pan control here. Here we go, finger style. Punchy, I mean really punchy sound. We are monitoring in the studio using the GR Bass Cube 800, which is a great little combo. We've got a nice tone coming from that, and hopefully if you're listening on decent speakers, I say this all the time, then you should hopefully be able to hear what this bass is all about. Okay, I'm gonna sweep the pan control around to the front, and this is the single coil pickup in the neck position on its own. Middle position, we've got the two coils in parallel with each other. And then we've got serial mode, both pickups essentially being added to each other. They're in series with each other. Loads and loads of extra volume and lots of mid-range there as well. If you're switching to that setting halfway through the set, I could probably use this as a solo volume for jumping out of the mix a little bit. But if you are switching between playing styles, then just be aware that there's a lot of difference in volume available there. That's actually a really good thing. Okay, let's go and listen to the back pickup on its own. Again, I'm going to zoom through these. We have got the single coil setting. Yeah, I was just listening to that whilst I was playing, and I really like that. Although it's changed to the bridge position, I don't actually seem to have lost a massive amount of low end. It's still punch, punch, punch. This is really, really cool. I like this a lot. Middle position, parallel. Let's see what this does. Exactly the same. A different tone, but still a nice punch in the low end. I'm expecting the volume to punch up in the serial setting. Here we go. Oh yeah. Yeah, really super nice. Again, lots and lots of volume there. And I think when you start comparing and combining the settings, then I could actually go with a louder sounding humbucker serial setting and maybe go with the single coil setting on the front pickup, half and half mix. Let's have a little listen to what that sounds like. Front pickup doesn't lose anything. Sometimes when you've got like a big serial humbucker on a front pickup, the front almost sounds a bit weedy. I'm not getting any of that at all. Let's go the other way around. I'm going to go with the serial mode on the front pickup, and I'm going to go with single coil on the back pickup. Nice and smooth. Try that with a bit of slap as well. I believe that's sustaining for absolutely ages. Tons of mid presence, tons of bite there, and I kind of actually like going with the fuller sound for the front pickup and then getting the zing from the bright single coil setting from the bridge. Yeah, that's really nice. Excellent. Coming around then, we have active bass and treble. And what I'll do is just to compare, I'm going to go back to the setting I had at the start of the video. So single coil and single coil, I suppose, is a bit like a jazz bass in some ways, isn't it? And we're going to have a little listen to what happens if I bring the bass control back. I had it boosted for the introduction, and I'm going to come back to the flat setting on both of the controls, bass and treble. Let's boost some bass. Let's cut some bass. I like that when I cut the bass there, I still got the actual tonal quality of the bass guitar coming through. It's still nice and woody. Let's come back. I'm just going to boost that back in again because I like it. It's nice. Treble control, I'm going to wind that back. So we're getting, I'm going to try and go vintage with this. Let's pull that treble control all the way back and see what that does with my jazz bass kind of tone. Nice, still mid-range in there, that's lovely, but I think maybe I wouldn't go that far. A little bit more in. Little tweak. Yeah, that's better. I've got a softness to the tone, but I can still dig in and get a little bit of a bite there. That's going to sit in the mix quite nicely. But hey, sometimes we don't want to sit in the mix nicely. I'm going to boost the treble out. Let's make it a bit more gnarly. Let's make it bite. Yeah, a nice bit of zing there. It starts to have that sort of Music Man type pickup sound, I guess. This is both of the switches in the middle. So this is the parallel settings with that nice bright sound. And then because we like an all-out assault, I'm gonna go for serial setting. The output is going to be much higher, so this is where you're going to want to watch the gain on your amplifier. Lots of volume. I had to watch that. I actually played a little bit more lightly so I didn't start clipping the input stage on our recording device, but the volume jumped up, the punch was still there, and we had that cool top end zing in there as well. I'm really liking, in a relatively short time, I've got a whole bunch of different sounds. Which one do I pick? I guess I'm gonna have to figure out which one works in a band setup, or depending on what my ensemble is that I might be playing. So there we go, a quick whistle stop tour of this bass. Of course, check out the written review in the magazine as well. But I think this one's getting a good thumbs up from me. So the Warwick Corvette Double-Buck in this lovely ocean blue. Cheers for watching, and I'll see you again soon.